Very, very happy to have back with us tonight, I think, one of the most scintillating stars on the stage today, the star of Hello, Dolly. Particular pleasure to introduce one of the most ebullient and effervescent girls in musical comedy, and dressed in the damnedest costume you ever saw in your life. And here she is in person, Carol Channing.
Thank you. Since tomorrow is Washington's birthday and we must all be truthful, I would like to say in introducing this distinguished panelist that aside from her tremendous contribution to the institution of motherhood, literature, charity, finance, and the arts,
sex.
I think they perform their service for men, which is not the superior sex. It's an equal sex.
She has also just recently become a bride to Professor Moriarty, so to speak. That is, her husband, of long standing, the renowned Martin Gable, just opened in the Broadway musical show Baker Street, portraying Dr. Moriarty, and this lady that I am about to introduce will take under herself a lover. That is, she will star in the forthcoming production. Mrs. Dolly Takes a Lover. I give you the ever loving Arlene Francis.
That was so marvelous, Carol, that we don't mind that the half hour is already up.
Carol, that's the most wonderful introduction I ever heard. Lovely to have you with
us. Thank you.
Are you in the entertainment business?
Yes.
Mr. Sir?
Do you sing as part of your regular act?
Yes.
Miss Francis?
Would you also be considered a leading man? Well, there's only one woman in all of show business that can do that with her voice, and I think it's Carol Channing.
Ah, you're right.
I thought I was way out of my range.
If you'd never done the high one, oh no, it sounded like you in the low register too, I must say. Oh. You look ravishing.
Oh, thank you, Arlene. What a nice feeling you give me.
You always had a nice feeling.
Could I ask you a question that's a little bit personal? Yes. Is that your real hair or is that a wig?
It's a wig.
I thought.
How wonderful. You really wondered.
I really wondered.
Oh,
yes.
Good. Most people know right off it's a wig.
I know.
On account of diamonds are a girl's best friend. Could I give one to you, John?
A diamond?
Yes.
Why, ma'am, I don't know what I've done to deserve it.
I know you're not the type to wear it, so you can give it to your best girl or to your wife, and you'll be surprised how nice she'll be to you. She'll just love you to pieces, John.
Why, I thank you very much.
Yes.
Very nice.
And do you suppose I can give one to the two girls, to my old friend Betty Furness?
You bet you could.
There, and one for Arlene.
Thank you.
That
did you ever play baseball?
Right.
That's a remarkably good arm, I must say.
Oh, do you think so? I haven't even got my glasses on. That's good. I'm so sorry we guessed it right away. What'll we talk about?
Well, we don't have to. I'm going to suggest, since I would like you to give them the pleasure of a personal good night, that you can deliver all the rest of those
if you could get it off, John.
If I can get it off, there we are.
I and I were going to be out of luck.
Yeah, I did too. Yeah.
Oh, no, no,
maybe
Bennett.
George would give us ours.
No, Alan, I know Alan very well, way back. Alan Ledden and I were in the Army together.
Oh,
do you ever sing for your supper?
Supper!
Have you appeared in the Broadway musical theater?
Oh, she also can't be sitting on the moon girl. Come to the kingdom of farms in the pool.
Must be baby Peggy.
Yes. Mr. Lewis.
I have a hunch. I'm going to go for it. Are you currently starring in one of the great musicals on Broadway? The greatest, I would say. Yes. Is it Carol Channing?
Yeah.
Show business, your principal vocation?
Yep.
Do you have anything to do with music?
Yep.
Do you appear in the hotel club? Nightclubs?
Yep.
Seven to go, Miss Francis.
Are you appearing at the present time in New York in a club?
Yes.
Mr. Sir?
Place where you're appearing, a big hotel?
Yes.
Miss Kilgallen?
Are you Carol Channing?
Jack, Mr. Hilton told me he gave me a brand new shipment of diamonds, and Dorothy wasn't here before. So could I give you a diamond and one for dear Dorothy because she looks so wonderful, and one for you, Peter Cook,
you'll
and
be over
Arlene.
There in a minute, Carol. Anyway, you can give them all.
Mrs. Sir.
And I still have the loot from last year.
Do you?
But for coming to see us, and I know you're going to have lots of fun this
Oh,
summer.
John, I'm glad to see you all again. Arlene is in Chin Chin. I'm coming to see you.
Well, you ought to see. I must say that Miss Daly and I have seen Arlene in Chin Chin, and I've always known that she was a great lady and a great actress, but she proves it again. She just is magnificent in Chin Chin.
Oh, yes. Arlene, come and ride the new gold escalator with me. I miss you.
At the Waldorf, I'll be over.
Will
we'll
you
go
do
up
that?
Yes.
This gets a little confusing. Wait a minute. Where is the gold escalator?
Oh, it shoots you just like a laundry chute right up into the Empire Room. It's the most marvelous thing, isn't it? It's all gold, Dorothy.
Wonderful.
Solid?
Yes, solid. Well, Mr. Hilton.
The only kind.
Carol, thank
the
you.
The only
so
kind.
Much.
Yeah.
Lovely to
thank
have you.
Thank you, Jack.
Nightclub engagement here in New York?
No.
That's three down and seven to go, Mr. Gable. Do you sing?
Yes.
Miss Francis?
Beautifully.
Since there was such an enormous laugh on our guest's answer about her singing, may I assume that is not primarily for what our guest is known?
Very well known as a singer.
Oh, very well known.
Yep. Five down and five to go.
For a popular kind of singing as opposed to operatic singing?
Yeah. Mr. Gable, I passed to my wife, Miss Francis.
Why did you do that? Suffering in the last year.
Last year in a musical.
Yeah. Is Carol Channing back in town? Is it?
I think if we'd braced her, though, Carol, she might have changed her mind, but the applause
gave
it away.
Arlene would get it. I just flew in from Chicago.
I thought you were on the road still.
Yes, she flew in from Chicago.
We're playing Hello, Dolly in Chicago.
That's what I thought.
Yeah.
What are you doing here?
Well, it's very cold.
You had the outfit.
Well, it's blizzard.
Do you have a dress on, Carol?
It's very cold. I came in to see old friends like you, Arlene, and Martin, and new friends.
To be fair, you know, I told you we'd played some tricks, and you've got to admit we played a trick on you. We did ask Carol if she would fly in from Chicago, where she's doing Dolly, and you'd have no idea that anybody like Carol Channing would be in New York, and we hoped to hang you completely with it. We came pretty close, 8-2.
It was so nice of her to do it, I just can't get over it.
You wrote me a letter while I was in Chicago. Arlene wrote me a letter. She did. I was so homesick, and I was so glad to get your letter.
Well, I don't see why you were homesick.
And I've been made an Indian.
You've been made an Indian?
Yes, and
what's your name?
The Oto tribe. My name is Princess Bakahi Dakun, which means blazing star.
Blazing star.
Yes.
Is this a leading lady?
Miss Francis?
She's not a wee leading lady, I don't think. Are you about to open in a musical that has been very successful already on Broadway? Are you related in a kind of mysterious way to Bennett, sir?
That's question number two, Miss Francis.
Sorry, sir.
Sorry,
let me ask that. All right. Are you related to a very close relation of mine, namely my wife?
No.
Are you Ginger Rogers?
Well, I think we're caught well up the tree now, and I'm out on the limb, and somebody's got
Well, you either are or you aren't Ginger Rogers.
No. Maybe there are two people there.
Are there two people?
Maybe it's
Ginger and Carol.
Ginger and Carol. Yeah.
You can see I was in a very difficult position, Bennett, because actually Carol answered your question very properly. No, but Ginger is also the mystery guest, so that
I wish Carol was my relationship.
It's awful, John. You have such problems.
That's why I'm aged.
Look at you sitting there with those two beauties. Gosh, what a lovely picture.
Would we know you from the Broadway boards or stage?
Well,
are you appearing at the present time in a Broadway production? Are you a performer in musicals rather than straight plays?
Now I could play Lady Macbeth if I wanted.
Anyone have a guess?
Yes, Carol Channing.
It is.
Oh, Arlene. Arlene. I'm on my way to Bonwit Tellers to do my Easter shopping because Arlene is she's one of the board of directors of Bonwit Tellers. You wouldn't think she was all that smart, but she is.
I'm not, but when you said you could play Lady Macbeth now, that's what
did it.